This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, finally tonight, almost all of the nation's anthracite coal comes from Pennsylvania. In 1917, the state's production peaked when more than 100 million tons of coal were mined from underground operations across our Commonwealth. Al's Massimi takes us underground in a Carbon County mine that's a museum these days.
For these people, the trip down this dark, dripping passageway is just another stop on their vacation. But for coal miners, constant darkness defined their jobs.
When a miner went to work in the mines, he did not know whether he was coming home that day or not.
For the most part, mining is now a thing of the past. Left behind are the memories and the abandoned mines.
Go!
Welcome to the No. 9 Mine and Museum in Lansford, a tribute to a way of life, a hard way of making a living.
It's our heritage. That's the main thing, it's our heritage. And everybody should remember it, and this is the only thing that's going to keep it alive. If we didn't have this last mine here, and have all these stories, and have this information, it's only a short few years, we've been all forgotten about, and pretty soon mining, what's that?
Which is why David Kuchka and others set out to reopen the No. 9 mine. Not as a profitable business, but to teach people about mining. 3 days a week, you can get a peek at this mine and the life of those that toiled in the dark, dusty, and damp environment.
In 1972, when this mine shut down, it was the oldest, longest-running deep anthracite coal mine in the world. Bar none, a record we're still holding and hope to hold for a while longer. You're going to get some really good shots.
The tour begins when you board a train and head for the dark abyss, a bumpy ride that can, for some, be a little scary. After about a five-minute ride, we arrive at our destination.
Right now, we're 1,600 feet inside the No. 9 mine. Now, the atmosphere in here is completely different from what we just came from outside. It's about 52 degrees in here, and it's also really humid. You can notice there's water dripping from the ceilings and also the walls.
Okay, folks, good morning. Welcome to the No. 9 mine. My name's Larry Consoli. I'm going to be your tour guide. Six veins run between two mountain ranges that are about 2 miles in width. They run like maybe the letter W from the surface and go down eventually to a basin. Now the veins vary in width from 2 feet to about 150 feet in width. All the veins got names.
Starting 9 miles east of where we're standing and continuing on into Dauphin County, the first vein of coal we see is the Orchard vein.
This is a staging area. All the coal cars were brought here. 32 coal cars were brought here. In the early years, you had 8 mules take these 32 coal cars out to the breakers across the street. Later in time, about 1915 to 1920, then the coal cars were taken out by electric motors.
We continue on walking down a dark hallway, lit by a few bare bulbs hanging from the walls.
Okay, folks, what you're looking at here is the No. 9 mine shaft. It was sunk or driven in the year 1900 from 200 feet above us, vertically straight down to 900 feet to a sump at the bottom.
Thankfully, we stay on the first level of the mine. But miners used to hop on these elevators and head down to the far-reaching depths of the mine.
What you're looking at here are two cages which are locked in place. Originally there were 8 hangers in each cage. It's where 8 miners would go in, go up and down on the hour. In between the hour you had the mules go up and down, and the full and empty coal cars would go up and down.
We're offered a peek down the 900-foot mine shaft, a view you have to see for yourself.
Okay, this is the mule way that they brought the mules up and down, and this connects with the other tunnel. And as you can see, it's only about four feet wide.
At the other end of the mule way is an escape tunnel. It's 265 feet up to the surface, a long way up if something like a cave-in were to happen down here, which we soon find out did take place.
I want you to walk to that wooden rail. What you're going to look at is actually a real cave-in that happened.
It's not known if anyone was hurt, but if they were right next to the hospital. A good thing to have, since mining is one of the most dangerous jobs. It's estimated that since 1870, more than 50,000 miners died in mining accidents. All for this.
Look up when you get to that wooden rail and you're going to see that black shiny mineral. That is your anthracite coal, the cleanest burning coal.
After taking a quick glance at what put eastern Pennsylvania on the map, we're boarding the train again, this time headed for some fresh air and sunlight, leaving with a clearer picture of what it means to be a miner.
The guide really talked a lot about the realities of not only the mine, but the miner's life and their family and the heartaches and hardships they had. and the risks and the dangers of mining.
What do you think about the conditions?
Horrible. Makes me think that not getting my lunch break really isn't that bad.
It's a trip that entertains us and helps us appreciate an almost forgotten piece of history. For Tempo, I'm Alice Massimi reporting.